We have decided. Membership will take effect from the 1st of January 2024.
I swear you don't understand what a turning point this is in human history. How revolutionary it is that BRICS have expanded from 5 to 11 members in one fell swoop. Just like that, overnight. Do you guys know that in its new form, BRICS countries will represent half of the world's population, 30% of global GDP as it is, 43% of global oil production. Jesus, it's dripping oil. Oh my God. With Argentina joining the BRICS countries, they will now have two of the largest countries, the largest economies, in South America. Africa will go from 1 to 3 BRICS members. Egypt with its access to the Mediterranean Sea, the Red Sea, the Suez Canal. They fought wars over that canal. And Ethiopia, one of Africa's fastest growing economies. And finally, last but not least, the oil and gas rich countries, Saudi Arabia, Iran, and the United Arab Emirates. These are titans. These are titans. And you must understand, BRICS is an organization, a bloc that has openly called for de-dollarization. So having Saudi Arabia, the backbone of the petrodollar, join BRICS. Oh, my, I mean, you couldn't make up a bigger slap in the face. It was already bad when, you know, last year Joe Biden went begging to Saudi Arabia, asking them for some extra oil so he can, you know, push prices down and make himself look good in the midterms. They told him no, no. And on top of that, it's not Russia, it's Saudi Arabia who in OPEC Plus insisted on a 2 million barrel per day cut in oil production. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. So, slap in the face after slap in the face from the Saudis to the Americans. And now, you know, instead of normalizing ties with Israel, which was what was expected of the Saudis after Bahrain and UAE, instead of doing what the Americans want, the Saudis do a 180 and go normalize with Iran, Yemen, Syria. I can guarantee you, they are not feeling very good right now in Washington, D.C. This BRICS summit, you had 40 world leaders, heads of state, that attended. I was accredited to cover the BRICS summit. I watched countless heads of state and presidents speak, presidents from every corner of the planet. And in almost every single speech, it's the same theme. They're talking about de-dollarization, decolonization, and a multipolar world. BRICS has existed for 15 years now, so why all of a sudden do you have 23 countries applying to join? 40 countries that have expressed interest in BRICS. You know, I'll tell you why. Because in addition to the disgust and resentment that the global South feels towards the Bretton Woods system that was put in place after World War II, towards the neo-colonial system where nothing changed. In addition to that, when last year the Americans thought it would be a good idea to, you know, just steal $300 billion, it's just $300 billion, in front of the whole world while everyone was watching. Oh yeah, we're gonna freeze $300 billion from Russia's central bank, you know, just take our Forex, their foreign exchange reserves. Nothing like this has ever happened. This is unprecedented. even for the United States, this was, you know, a new low. And so now you got countries all over the world who are looking at this, you know, with their jaws wide open, thinking, wait, am I going to be next? What if I make you angry? What if I make Uncle Sam angry? Is he going to come and steal my reserves, you know, my assets in the United States? What's he going to do with my forex? They're stealing from central banks? So now countries, after witnessing the spectacle, are dumping their dollars. They are trading in their own currencies. They are withdrawing their assets from the United States and anywhere the US can reach. And they are applying to join BRICS. Like they banned Russia, sanctioned Russia, removed it from SWIFT, they did the same to Iran. A lot of people forget. They tried to isolate Iran internationally in every manner possible and imaginable. But despite this, despite the US best efforts to crush Iran, look at Iran. Who has been isolated, man? We have been isolated. We isolated ourselves in the UK and in the US. Look what we've done. We have morons running these countries. Iran is now in the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, in the SDO. Iran is now a permanent member of BRICS. You call that isolation? Wow. Bunch of geniuses right here. These sanctions are not only illegal and immoral, they're also stupid and they backfire. You know, this gold-backed trade currency that was rumored to be announced, you know, people were hyping this up before. I told you guys, there is no guarantee that they will announce a gold-backed trade currency at the BRICS summit, nor any guarantee that they will accept new members, okay? And then on day three, they dropped the bombshell that, look, we've added all these countries, right? We've beefed up our presence in all the continents. Now, the thing is that people think, well, you know, this is an issue that is going to take time, and we're not going to hear about it for a while. And you're right. This is an issue that takes time, right? You cannot just de-dollarize, you know, from one day to the next. No one actually expects to wake up tomorrow morning and, you know, the dollar is gone. Sanctions are gone. The weaponization of the greenback is gone. What BRICS is doing, however, and this is a form of de-dollarization nonetheless, is that, you know, the BRICS, the original five, they created a bank known as the New Development Bank, or NDB. Now, this BRICS bank, as I like to call it, they have issued this month bonds in South African rand. And in 2 months, in October 2023, the NDB will issue bonds in rupees. The NDB just announced that it will issue 30% of its loans in its own tender, all right, local tender. So that means currency that belongs to BRICS members, rubles, rupees. Do you understand? That means not US dollars, no US dollars for that one third of their loans. This is explosive. This is colossal. The New Development Bank really is about development. See, that's the difference. It is actually what it says on the tin. The NDB wants to genuinely help countries build themselves up, specifically in the Global South. The NDB has $100 billion in capital, which means they can borrow hundreds of billions of dollars more if they need to. The NDB is not BRICS equivalent to the International Monetary Fund or the World Bank. No. It is their solution to these two institutions, the World Bank and the IMF, who are infamous for robbing and debt trapping poor developing countries, right? The IMF and World Bank will come to you and say, oh, we care about you. We want to invest in your country and help you out of this poverty that you're in, this situation that you're in. They're no better than a loan shark in some dark alley. There are always strings attached, and these are the worst of conditions that you can imagine. The true objective of the IMF and the World Bank is to control countries by keeping them trapped in debt. That is the whole plan. Now, this BRICS summit was not just some random get-together of presidents. BRICS countries contain some of the largest economies on the face of the planet. of the law.